All right. So our content tonight is crypto asset classification, crypto wallets, crypto exchanges overview and deposits, coin market cap capitalization, coin markets capitalization, understanding Satoshi value. Okay. This whole talk in this content section might seem so simple to you. Okay. But they have a lot to do. I want you to understand that foundation of everything in life matters. If you don't have the proper foundation, then you will struggle in that area. And again, the knowledge you have about something determines your success in that area. Okay, in whatsoever you are doing, the level of knowledge you have determines what you make next or what your success or your achievement is going to look like. So pay close attention to this so that you have a very nice background and foundation in this space. Okay, I never had this opportunity during my time because it was so rough, nobody even believed in it. You have to search and search, you have to make a lot of mistakes, okay? But now, pay close attention so that you will learn everything that I'll be showing you tonight. Now, first we have crypto asset classifications, okay? While you are seeing crypto asset classifications instead of cryptocurrency classifications is that we have crypto assets. Is different from cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency is among them, but these are all these whole stuff an asset because it's something you are going to buy with your money. You have it. It becomes your property. You decide what to do with it at any time. All right. Now we have decentralized currency, which is where your cryptocurrencies comes in. Okay, that is the particular classification where cryptocurrency belongs in. You have decentralized currencies, okay? Example of these decentralized currencies is Bitcoin, the master of all crypto, like you already know, the very first and ever-growing crypto currency in the world. Decentralized currencies are blockchain assets designed to be used as money for payment of goods and services, just like the name implies. Okay, decentralized currency, just the difference between this and your Naira is that your Naira is just a fiat currency, okay? A physical currency you can lay your hands on, you can touch, you can hand it over to somebody, but this is purely currency, okay? But digital currency. Now, why is it regarded as decentralized? It's regarded as decentralized because nobody controls it, just like you have your bank. Okay, your bank controls the money you send. Even after the bank, there is another organization in between the bank, okay, that processes this transfer. If you transfer from one bank to another, that is why sometimes you do a transfer in the bank, the money will not get to the person you are sending it to, and the money will not be out. It will be in between. There is another organization in between. Okay, if I can remember the name correctly, they are known as Intercom or something like that. I can't remember. But I know that there is an organization between those two banks that you do transaction with. They have different, sorry about that. They have different operations and their ways of regulating this whole money you are sending. But this is decentralized, okay? It means me and you, we have control of it. Nobody is the middleman. You don't need to consult me before you send any of them. That's why it's decentralized. Okay, no, there is no middleman to control it. Examples of these coins is Bitcoin. We have Ripple, we have Monero, we have Dogecoin, we have Nano. Mention but a few, there are plenty. Okay, the original goal for these decentralized currencies, such as Bitcoin and others, was to make payments inexpensive, simple, importantly decentralized, free from third-party management. Just like I said, when you have a cryptocurrency, like a decentralized currency, you don't need a middleman to transact, okay? It's purely decentralized. Anybody has access to it. Please, everyone, mute your mic, okay? To avoid distractions. So that is the first classification of cryptocurrency, of crypto assets, which is decentralized what currency. And Bitcoin is included. And the goal, I want you to understand the full goal of these assets, okay? The full goal of it is just to serve as payment for goods and services. The way you use your Naira to buy and sell, okay? So for example, now I might have a plot of land to sell. I could say, okay, I will accept my payment in Bitcoins. You can't do anything, just go and buy Bitcoin and send to me. Okay, Bitcoin has served as that means of payment for the goods that I'm selling, all right? Then we have network or platform tokens. Okay, after decentralized currencies, we have network or platform tokens, okay? These are coins or tokens developed to be utilized in a particular blockchain platform for maintaining a decentralized payment network, but also for storing computer code, which can be used to power tamper-proof decentralized financial contracts and applications. Now, we have tokens or coins that are being used just in a particular platform or network. Example of these coins or tokens is Ethereum. I know you have heard of Ethereum countless times. Sometimes you wish we purchased Ethereum maybe years ago. Yeah. Ethereum is a platform token. It's different from Bitcoin. Bitcoin is just to be a currency like your Naira. What Ethereum is a coin which is meant to be used in a particular blockchain. And that blockchain is meant to be used in is Ethereum blockchain. Then why does Ethereum blockchain need a token? Okay, Ethereum blockchain need a token because of the operations going on that blockchain. Example is Ethereum was created to provide decentralized applications and decentralized finance. Okay, don't get confused about that. Okay, the decentralized finance is an advanced decentralized application. Okay, you will get to understand that maybe later on in other of our lessons, but just know that Ethereum was developed for decentralized applications and decentralized contracts. Okay, now that is the purpose of Ethereum. Now, its token, which is ETH, okay, ETH is being created to serve as gas fee. Like when you are doing anything on Ethereum blockchain, you are expected to pay your gas fee, or let's call it service fee. Okay, in the layman's language, service fee. You are meant to pay your service fees using Ethereum token. That is the reason why Ethereum is created, and that is why it's known as what network or platform token. It cannot be used in any other blockchain to solve any other issue apart from its own blockchain. Man, coins in this category of network or platform tokens are, we have Ethereum, we have Tron, we have Waves. This is to mention, but if you can easily search on Google to get more lists. So that is the second classification of digital assets. Okay, then the third one is privacy coins. Privacy coins. Please, someone should help me and type in that key that if you're having issue to join, close the Zoom app and launch that app, then try to join again. I have Antonia Okeke here trying to join for like more than 30 minutes now, and it's not going. So I believe it's her now. So let her close the Zoom app and try again. Someone should help me and release that information on the group. Okay, meanwhile, number three is privacy coins. Okay, privacy coins are unique tokens that allow a user to gain total anonymity when making blockchain. The identity of the user and the origin of their transaction are completely protected. These coins empower senders and receivers to remain anonymous with different level of privacy, like hidden wallet addresses and transaction balances. with credit cards, payments actually remains private. Now, for those of us who have started with Bitcoin many times, we have heard the story of Bitcoin being so decentralized, being so untrackable. The simple truth is Bitcoin is not completely private, okay? Bitcoin is not completely private. The same thing with Ethereum. There are a lot of, many of these coins are not completely private. What I mean by not completely private is with an advanced programming, they can actually dictate the exact location which you are sending these coins. Just that it is not easy to encrypt blockchain encryption. To decrypt blockchain encryption is not easy, okay? It takes high programming skills to be able to do that. That is why it's still very hard. But believe me that the way technology is going in the world, a time will come that they will have easy solution to decrypt all those Bitcoin wallets and their locations. Okay, so Bitcoin is not completely private. Bitcoin is not completely private. That is why we have other coins that are being created, other crypto assets that are being created. Actually, these people, please mute your mic, everyone. Now, that is why we have coins that are actually created to give people complete privacy. Okay, examples of those coins is Zcash. Okay, we have Zcash. We have Monero, we have Dashcoin, okay? These coins we are created to give people complete, like their own privacy is maximum, okay? From the moment you send them, they are completely encrypted till the receiver gets it. And if the receiver that gets it, receives it from unknown person or direction, and even the person that sent it don't really will never be able to dictate, no matter how hard it is, their own areas created with that mindset of being completely what? Private. Okay, that is the top classification of crypto assets. Then we have fourth classification, utility tokens. Okay, these are tokens created to provide user access to finished goods and services on a blockchain platform, especially allowing use of specific centralized application. Okay, so utility tokens, we have tokens or crypto asset that is known as utility tokens. Okay, their purpose is to be used in a particular organization or a particular institution. A utility token has a wider functionality than a coin. Utility tokens do have value, okay? But they cannot be considered money as straightforward as a coin. Utility tokens can provide value to investors in different ways. They give users access to future products and services. For example, we have Sia coin. Sia is a cloud storage network, okay, organization. They offer cloud storage for you to upload your data, your files, your videos online, okay? Now, they created Sia coin as a utility token. For you to pay them and for you to buy that space online, you need to buy it using their coin, which is what utility coin is, just meant to serve as money in that organization. Example is we have one Nigerian coin by Gaius Chibeze. The coin is TAFCoin. You might have seen TAFCoin before in the media. TAFCoin is a utility coin created to serve as means of payment in Abit Network. The name of the organization is Abit Network. They are into real estate, they are into farming, they are into agriculture. For you to buy anything from that organization, you need to buy it with that coin. So that coin is a utility token created for that particular organization. All right? So that is utility tokens. So we have a lot of them. You can go ahead to search for more in Google, okay? Then we have five. The fifth classification, we have stable coins. Stable coins, you know, if you have not been in crypto space for a long time, you know that you have been hearing all this story of Bitcoin is increasing, Bitcoin is falling, Ethereum is increasing, Ethereum is falling, Ripple is increasing. Yes, those coins are doing that, but we have coins that are stable. They don't move an inch. Their value becomes, their value is stable, okay? While the value of currencies like BTC, ETH are often highly volatile and driven by investors and speculations, stable coins such as Tether, MakerDAO, and Basecoin, among others, aim to create a price-stable cryptocurrency by fixing the value of their coin to a reward asset. Okay, stable coins are cryptocurrencies that attempt to peg their market value to some external references. Stable coins may be pegged to a currency like US dollar or to a commodity price such as gold. Now we have stable coins, okay? Just like the name implies, stable. It doesn't go up and it doesn't come down, all right? Now, example of that coin is Tether. That is USDT that you have been hearing. Tether, the abbreviation of Tether is USDT, okay? Which means Tether dollars, okay? So Tether is pegged to United States dollars. It means that one USDT is always equal to $1. Come rain, come sun, is always equal to $1. $1 cannot be higher than it, and it cannot be higher than $1. They are equal. They are equal, but is the difference is that this is a cryptocurrency, okay? This is a digital asset. Just that is being pegged to a reward asset like the US dollars. Okay, so it means that if you have 10,000 USDT, you have $10,000. Okay, the reason why USDT fluctuates sometimes is because of dollar to naira rate. Okay, because normally you know that your naira sometimes depreciates against the US dollar, sometimes it appreciates against, most of the times it depreciates, okay, against the US dollars. So that is why USDT might seem as if it's fluctuating, but it doesn't, okay? That is why one USDT today can be 480 per one, and tomorrow it can be 500. The reason is if dollar is increasing, the price is increasing because it's pegged to US dollars, okay? So that is the fifth classification of digital assets. All right, now we have the first one is decentralized currencies. We looked at network and platform tokens, we looked at privacy coins, we looked at utility tokens, and we looked at stable coins. Okay, so from today, don't get confused when you hear somebody say, I bought a utility token. Don't get confused. Just understand that this is a token created to serve as a payment in a particular organization or a firm. All right, then we'll be looking at crypto wallets. Most of us already know what cryptocurrency wallets are, okay? But we'll be looking at it for some of us who are yet to fully understand what it is. What is cryptocurrency wallet? A wallet is basically the equivalent of a bank account. It allows you to receive Bitcoins and other coins, store them, and then send them to others. Just your wallet, your cryptocurrency wallet or your digital asset wallet is equivalent to just your bank account, all right? The only difference here now is that this one is completely encrypted, okay? And its own account number is just jargon, okay? Series of code as a wallet address. That's just different there, all right? Then you can think of a wallet as your personal interface to the Bitcoin network, similar to how your online bank account is an interface to the regular monetary system. Wallets contain private keys, secret code that allow you to send your money, your coins. Now, in normal banking system, okay, Please mute your mic, everyone. In normal banking system, we have, if you forget your account number, you can easily walk to the bank and tell customer care, please, I forgot my account number, can you help me with it? And they will just ask you your name and some questions, okay? And they will give you your account number. But in cryptocurrency wallets, you need just the private key, the mnemonic phrase, or the secret code. Now, without this private key or secret code, your money is forever lost in this space, okay? So that is why you need this key. What? How you use this key is simple. Let's assume you are using Infinix, okay? You are using Infinix phone. You have your wallet in your Infinix phone, and your Infinix phone crashed, or you just woke up one day and you're like, ah, I want to upgrade Samsung, and I want to get Samsung food, okay? And you purchase Samsung food around 400,000 to 500,000, okay, for a better experience in mobile. Now you downloaded your wallet back, and maybe mistakenly you've even formatted the Infinix before you bought the Samsung phone. Now, for you to get your wallet back, you need your private key. The only thing you need to do in that new Samsung phone you purchased is to download the wallet you are using, then insert the private key. Automatically, it will retrieve all the money you have in your wallet to that your new device. Okay? Now, we have, in reality, it's not coins that need to be stored or secured, but the private keys that give you access to them. Okay, now cryptocurrency is a series of code in general. Okay, what you're actually storing is your private key that gives you access to view what you have, the asset you acquired. Okay, that is what you are actually using wallet to do. Wallet just shows you what you have been able, what like what you have in the blockchain. Okay, and it helps you to send it out or to receive. That is what the wallet has. But the main thing the wallet is actually securing is your private key. In short, a crypto or Bitcoin wallet is simply an app, website, or a device that manages private key for you. Then we'll be looking at types of wallets. We have software or hot wallets. We have software or hot wallets. Software wallets or hot wallets are wallets that run on internet connected devices like your computer, your mobile phone, or your tablet. Okay, private keys are secret code because hot wallet generates your private key on an internet connected device. These private keys can be considered 100% secured. Okay, so we have wallets, all right, they are considered as software or had a hot wallet. These are wallets that are on the internet. Okay, they provide you with an app. Sometimes you use their website. Like when we started, we are using blockchain websites to hold our bitcoins and just send and receive. After some time, they were able to develop an app which you can equally download. So that is just your hot wallet. Blockchain organization owns that wallet, okay? But they created it in a way that it gives you its own security key, so that your own security, your own private key, so that in case if you lose your device or you want to change your device, you can easily retrieve your wallet in the next device you have. So examples of this hot wallet: we have blockchain wallets, okay? We have trust wallets, we have atomic wallets, we have IAM token wallets. Now, blockchain wallets, which wallets should I use? Okay, I will explain this now. Blockchain wallet is a very nice wallet. In fact, the wallet is very, very nice. For years, they've maintained optimal security, all right? But the difference there is they are not that dynamic in nature. Okay, they don't accept many coins. Okay, they just accept like few coins. I think blockchain wallet accept Bitcoin, Ethereum, Paxos standard token. They accept Stellar Lumen. They accept USDT. Okay, so basically what blockchain wallet accepts is coins under Bitcoin blockchain and Ethereum blockchain. So if you are looking at holding a coin outside these two blockchains, blockchain wallets will not serve you, okay? But they are 100%, like not 100%, they're like 90%, just the 90% secure, okay? For years, they've been great, all right? Then we have Trust Wallet. Trust Wallet is a cross-chain wallet, okay? A cross-chain wallet is a wallet that can help you accept coin from any blockchain. It accepts from Binance blockchain, it accepts from Ethereum blockchain, it accepts from Tron blockchain. So Trust Wallet is just so dynamic in nature, okay? And they are equally very secured. Just that blockchain has made their name and they are older than Trust Wallet. So your choice of wallet depends on what you want to use them for, okay? If you are just looking for a way to secure just your Bitcoin and Ethereum, then you can use blockchain wallet. Other things in blockchain wallet is their charges is high, their transaction fees are high, but something you will discover along the line, then you find the one which is better for you. So Atomic Wallet is another wallet. Atomic Wallet is also a cross-chain wallet. IM Token Wallet, but I would suggest you to use blockchain and Trust Wallet. That is okay for you for now. If in future you have dream of using a better wallet or more wallets, then by then you already know what you are doing. Then we have hardware wallets, okay? A hardware wallet is a physical electronic device built for the sole purpose of securing crypto coins. The core innovation is that the hardware wallet must be connected to your computer, phone, or tablet before coins may be sent. Now, hardware wallet is like your flash drive, okay? Hardware wallet is like your flash drive. That is the most secured wallet in the world, okay? That is the most secured wallet in the world. That wallet comes online when you decide, and it lives online when you decide. That's why it's stated here that you can only send or receive when it's being connected to your computer, phone, or tablet. So it simply means that when you have a hardware wallet, you can actually take off your coins offline. And once that happens, no matter how good a hacker is, the hacker can never penetrate your hardware wallet, okay? But hot wallets, like your blockchain wallet, your Trust Wallet, if there is a major attack or there is an inside scam, hack, maybe some of the workers before change their mind and all that, and they try to hack, they can actually hack this wallet because you don't have full control of someone's products. But hardware wallet is entirely different because you can take it offline and take it online. So example of these hardware wallets, we have Ledger Nano X and we have Trezor T, okay? My own recommendation for hardware wallet is Ledger Nano X, okay? Then for you to consider a hardware wallet is when you're looking at saving maybe, let me say 2 million naira, 3 million naira, or you want to invest up to that amount in crypto, then you can get a hardware wallet. But if you are just looking for a way to host 100,000, 300, 1 million, you can use hot wallets, a good hot wallet like Trust Wallet and blockchain wallets. All right. So that is for wallets. Then warning, exchange, cryptocurrency exchange, like Binance, KuCoin are not wallets. They should never be used to store your crypto, your assets permanently. Example of this, people I'm mentioning now, we have Luno. Most of us might have Luno. We have Binance account, we have KuCoin account. Any exchange, just any exchange, shouldn't be regarded as a wallet. They are not wallets because they will never give you your private key. It's not possible. So it means that if any money you save in that exchange is being hacked, then your money is lost. So have this one in your mind. Okay, crypto exchange overview, deposit and withdrawal. This is a practical session of this lesson tonight. Let me see how I can get that for you. Okay. Hold on, let me try to log in. Okay. All right, so I'll just show you Binance. Now, this is Binance. Binance is a cryptocurrency exchange. All right. In this exchange, global exchange, the top leading cryptocurrency exchange in the world as we speak. There's no other exchange that is higher than Binance. So it simply means that you can buy and sell in this Binance and are highly secured. Binance has been hacked a few years ago. They ended up paying everybody back the money that was moved out of their system. So they have proven that themselves to be very trustworthy and capable. In fact, right now in the crypto space, Binance helps other exchanges that maybe have issues. Okay, so it's an exchange I highly recommend, and they have almost all the cryptocurrency in the world in their exchange. So all you have to do is very simple. You come on Binance, you just click on register, and you create your accounts. Okay, I will walk you through. You can do that. Then this is login. Then this is Binance logo. You can see my mouse pointer. Then you see here, let's just overlook this. This you go through yourself. When you come on buy, we have bank deposits, we have credit cards, we have P2P trading, we have cash balance, we have third party payments. You can talk after I'm done, please. So if we go to bank, normally have a bank deposit, okay? But because of last month, Binance stopped accepting deposits. So right now in Binance, you cannot deposit your direct naira. You can only send cryptocurrency or buy coin from the P2P section of this issue. Then credit card and debit card. This is the section where you can be able to buy. Please, everyone, mute your mic. Please, I beg you. All right, sorry about that. Then this is the where you buy with your credit card and your debit card. The truth is Nigeria stopped processing dollar transaction. Talk more of where you are trying to access a cryptocurrency website. Okay, the bank don't allow their card to be used. Okay, so this is a dead end for now until Nigeria change their mind. Then we have the P2P section in Binance. We have the P2P section. Now, this P2P section is just very simple. This just means person to person trading. Okay, what it simply means is you will buy from anybody here, you pay that person directly into that person's bank account, and that person will release your coin for you. Now, you might ask, how secure is it? It's very secure. Binance is an exchange, and anybody that is selling coin here has sent like these people selling Bitcoin now, they've sent their Bitcoin to Binance, it's already their Binance wallet, okay, before they can post this ad. Now, what Binance will do is, if I click on this buy, Binance will secure. Let me try and log in, okay, so that I can maybe show you about it. All right. Now, this is Binance B2B section. Like as I was saying, if I click on this Bitcoin now, I want to buy Bitcoin from this B2B section from Binance. What I will do is if I click on buy, it gives me this window. It shows me terms and conditions. You can see this person's terms and conditions. Please look at that in the description. No Binance, no Bitcoin, no Ethereum, no USDT in the description. Okay, this is his own, I can't pronounce this his name, but this is his own terms and conditions. So if I want to buy him, let's assume I want to buy everything he has here now. I'll simply just click on this all. Okay, if I click on this all, it gives me estimate. This is what I will see, and this is the money I will pay. Okay, you can see it's written here. Let me draw it out for you if you can see it. He said what I want to pay, this is what you are going to pay, and this is what you are going to receive. Okay, that is what you are going to pay, and this is the Bitcoin you are going to receive. So if I click on buy, once I click on buy, what Binance will do, Binance will automatically secure this, Binance will lock up this person's Bitcoin. This person can no longer have access to this coin ever again. Okay, so the person cannot have access to it till maybe for him to have access to it, I need to cancel this coin. Please mute your mic, I beg you. Okay, sorry about that. Now the person cannot, will no longer have access to this coin till I cancel this transaction. If I make payment to this person and this person refuses to confirm that I've made payments, now Binance support team will come in between this transaction and they will ask us to provide our bank statement. Okay? If we provide our bank statement, definitely our bank statement will indicate if I actually made this payment or if he actually received. So if he received my money and he refused to release the coin, very simple, Binance will release the coin for me because they've locked that coin immediately I clicked on this buy. Now, what I will do is look at his bank statement, his bank details. You can see his bank details here. He's using Kuda Microfinance Bank. And you can see his name. If I just copy this account number, send this amount of money to him, 342,604.93 Kobo. Once I send it to his account, I will just come here and click on transfer and next. Immediately I click on transfer and next, Binance will notify him that I have made payment. Then he will wait till he see the money in his account. Once he see the money in his account, he will come back to Binance. Just like I have this transfer and next, he will have release. His own, he's going to have release here. Once he click release, automatically this Bitcoin will move from his own wallet to my own Binance wallet. So that is how simple P2P section is. Now, I don't want to buy from this guy. I have to cancel this transaction. It's for purpose so that I can release his coin and let him go and sell his coin off. Now, that is how P2P section works in Binance. Okay, so that is for the P2P section. It's still loading. Okay. Third-party payment, this has to do with Simplex. This is a payment processing network that accepts credit cards. Okay, so this is for people who are still looking for a way to buy with their credit card or MasterCard, and you want to use a third-party network organization that Binance is in partnership with. Okay, so but credit card is dead in Nigeria, and you can't buy anything with that. Then if you come on market section on this Binance, this section shows you every coin on Binance. Okay, it shows you the list of the coins. The list of the coins in Binance, you can see this is the pair. Pair simply means the coins you are using to buy one or two, like maybe Bitcoin USDT or Bitcoin Ethereum. That is the pair. This is CHZ. So BNB, BNB is Binance Basic Coin. Okay, that is their own coin, for this their platform. So they always have their own trading pair for this coin, okay, for this, in this their market section. So you get to see, this is the pair, okay, this is the last price, which is the current price of this coin. This is the current price of it. Then this is 24 hours change. Now this 24 hours change simply means the percentage in gain or percentage in loss that this coin has witnessed in Binance for the last 24 hours, all right? You can see it's green. When it's in green, it simply means this coin has made 32.56% for the last 24 hours, okay? Then this red shows that this coin has been on a downward movement. It has been falling for the last 24 hours. So that is the 24 hours change. Now, this is 24 hours high. This 24 hours high is the highest price that this coin has, each of these coins has increased, has reached for the last 24 hours. So every coin in this market session has the same 24 hours high. All right. Then 24 hours low, this is the lowest they've sold this coin for the last 24 hours. Don't calculate this 24 hours to be your own 24 hours. Okay. Just know that there's time difference in this thing because this is a global system, and as such, your time is different from their own time. Okay, this last 24 hours might have been like maybe around 2 o'clock or around, it depends, but you can't actually have the exact estimate of this last 24 hours because you don't know when their own 24 hours started. So their market cap, this is the total amount of money, which is market capitalization. This is the total amount of money that has been traded into this coin for the last 24 hours. Okay, this is the whole amount, which is $1.3 million. I mean, say $1.3 million has been traded into this coin in the last 24 hours. Then you have 24 hours boom. This is the number, the quantity of this coin that has been purchased for the last 24 hours in Binance. So all these market cap, all of them is just activity going on in Binance. Okay, in this particular coin. All right, so anytime you come here, don't just get confused. Now, you can see this is BNB market. This BNB market simply means coins you can buy with Binance Basic Token, which is BNB. Okay, that is what it simply means. So when you click on BTC market, you will now see all the coins you will buy with using Bitcoin to buy. The simple truth is, every coin is valued against Bitcoin. So every cryptocurrency, you can buy them using Bitcoins. All right? So then you see alt market. Alt simply means alternative coins. We have alt coins. Alt coins are cryptocurrencies that are not Bitcoin. Every other cryptocurrency after Bitcoin is regarded as an alternative to Bitcoin. Okay, so every other coin apart from Bitcoin is an alternative. Ethereum is an alternative, just the crypto space is about 8,400 coins. Okay, so those let's say 8,400, which means that 8,399 is an alternative coin. The only coin that is not alternative is Bitcoin. So when you see this alt market in Binance, simply understand that this is a section where you see other coins that is not Bitcoin or BNB that you can use and buy other coins. Like here now, this BTT, you can use Tron to buy it. So Tron abbreviation is TRX. You can use XRP to buy Tron, and that is just it. So you take your time to go through this. Future markets, okay? In trading, both forex trading and crypto trading, they have future and spot trading. Now, spot trading is a kind of trading that involves you buying cryptocurrency with your money. Okay, you buy them and hold the coin. When the coin increases, you sell, or if the coin is decreasing, you want to sell, you sell. But future trading, you are not buying real life assets. You are not buying Bitcoin. You are only buying the price of Bitcoin. In other words, you are betting on the price of that coin. So if you are trading future now, you are simply saying, okay, Bitcoin will increase in price. That is what you are betting your money. If Bitcoin should fall below what you have predicted, your money is gone. So future is completely risky. But future trading, if you have done binary option, all this IP option, expert option, that is this thing I'm talking about. So it's just you buying the price of this coin, not the asset itself. So that's why you see here we have spots. We have, okay, we have spot markets and we have futures. Then we equally have margin trading. Margin trading is just future trading, but an advanced future trading that gives you option to borrow money from an exchange, okay, or a broker for people that is trading forex, okay. Then that is margin. Margin means you can easily borrow money from, like as Binance is, if you are trading margin, you can borrow money from Binance, okay, and you trade with it, make gain with it, and you sell back. You pay them back. Okay. So that's margin as we continue. So that is for the market section. The market section. Then when you come on trade section, okay, if you click on convert, sorry, I'm tricking. If you click on convert, this simply means you changing from one coin to another. So let's say I have USDT now in Binance. Okay, I think I have 28 USDT here. So if I want to change it to Bitcoin, I'll just add that 28. Okay, and it will show me the quantity of Bitcoin it will give me. Okay. I don't really know if my network is done, supposed to have shown, but let me preview. So that is just for the convert. All right, you can see it simply shows that $28 I have here, okay, will give me 0.0051 Bitcoin. Okay, so that is for convert. Simply means changing from one coin to another. Okay, but the reason I don't use this, I personally I don't use it because there is a lot of charges in this. Changing from this coin to this now is very high. So if I go back to trade session, you have classic. You have classic. This is the trading interface of Binance in classic. This is the classic interface of Binance trading. This here now, you have here you can see BTC, USDT. This is the pair you are trading. It simply means you are buying Bitcoin using USDT or you are selling Bitcoin using USDT. Now we have the order book. This thing you see moving up and down is called order book. Okay, this order book, the red ones, the ones in red is selling orders. Okay, while this green is buying orders. Now you see these things are moving up and down. The reason is because millions of people are right here buying and selling Bitcoin. All these things you see is orders from individuals. That is, they keep going up and coming down. As people are selling off, more people are putting order to sell. Okay, you see the prices they are selling here, and you see the quantity of Bitcoin they are selling, and you see the total amount of money they are going to make if they sell this quantity. So that is the order book. So the red ones are the selling orders, and the green ones are the buying orders. Then here we have the charts that you can read. Your charts, okay. I'm not going to go over reading charts because that is separately and a cumbersome area, okay. Just overlook it for now. We'll get down to it later on. Then here you have where you buy, where you sell. Okay, this is where you buy, this is where you sell on the exchange, on the trade section. All right. So our lesson today. Is not, our lesson today, and the content doesn't involve me showing you how to buy and sell. So that will be, I think that will be in our tomorrow lesson. Then here, you have the market again, you have the trading pair. Here is where you select the coin that you want to trade, okay? Then this is market trade, combination of the order book is what you are seeing here, okay? So just, I will explain this more better when we are going through buying and selling. All right. Then derivatives. Like I said, derivatives has to do with future trading, margin trading, and all of them. Like I explained, that is all these things. I don't trade margin and I don't trade future. Okay, so I wouldn't be showing you all this, but just understand that this is for future trading and margin trading. Maybe in my tomorrow class with you, I'll tell you why I don't trade future margin. Then finance, this is for Binance, other products Binance has and projects they do. Okay, you can take your time to go through them. Then wallets, okay. When you come in wallet, you see overview, you see fiat and spot. Okay, if you click on overview, it takes you to seeing your balances. Okay, now in Binance, you have different wallets. Okay, you have the fiat and spot wallet, you have the cross margin wallet, you have the isolated margin wallet, and you have the future wallet. The reason why they created a separate wallet for you is because if you are trading spot, you use spot wallet. Okay, if you are trading margin, you use margin. If you are trading different kind of margin you want to trade, I explained initially what margin is. Then this is future trading too. Then for P2P, for you to sell your coin in P2P, you must forward them to what this P2P. Okay, this is Binance AIM. Maybe you need any promo or so that Binance introduces and that can you earn anything from them. This is where the money will be. This is Binance Pool. We'll talk on Binance Pool later on, not now. Then just this is breakdown of the this is breakdown of your wallet. So we that is trading spot wallet, we use that is trading spot, we use spot wallet, and this is the major wallet in Binance. This is where the coins you have is being stored. It's from this spot wallet, you can then transfer to any of these wallets. So transfer from here is very easy. If you come at this top, you see transfer here. When you click on this transfer, you can transfer from each of these wallets to one another. So deposits, okay? Deposit is included in our today lesson. When you click on deposit, okay, you can see deposit cash. Deposit cash is not working for Nigerians now, but I think it's still working for South Africans and Ghanaians. Okay, so deposit doesn't work for Nigeria. Cash deposit doesn't work. What works is crypto deposit. Okay, so when you click on crypto and you want to deposit, you come on Binance, you click on crypto, you see this interface. All right. Now, for you to deposit, you need to select the coin you want to deposit here. You can see this place is with root BTC. You can select any of these coins. Okay, you can simply search for them. Let's say I want to deposit dots. I search on dots, it pops up dots. I can click on dots. Then when you click on it, you see the wallet address by your right side. You can copy this wallet address and send to anybody. Please give me a moment. All right, sorry about that. I had to take a call. Now, let me use Bitcoin, the coin you already know. So if you come here on deposit and you click on Bitcoin, okay, you see your Bitcoin wallet address. This is your Bitcoin wallet address. Then up here, you will see deposit network. Okay. You will see deposit network. Sorry about that. I've muted you. Now, when you come here, you see deposit network, right? This deposit network, because we have different blockchains, okay? So it depends on where you are depositing. But the main BTC is selected here for you. That is why you can see this yellow line under BTC. So this is the main BTC wallet that Binance is giving you. Now, you see this BEP2 and BEP20. BEP2 and BEP20. BEP2 is Binance Smart Chain. Okay, the 20 is Binance Smart Advanced, like upgraded Binance Smart Chain. This is the first blockchain they created, and they advanced it here, okay, which they consider as BSC. All right, what it simply means, Binance created in this blockchain, you can accept Bitcoin. Okay, if you are using a wallet that accepts Binance blockchain, you can withdraw using each of these. This stuff, okay? If you want Bitcoin to be created under Ethereum, okay, you use this ERC20. ERC20 simply means Ethereum tokens, okay? So, but for your major BTC, just focus on this. For your major BTC, just this BTC. So anytime you want to send somebody wallet to send you money and you want to receive it in Binance, you just, the first one I'll select for you is this major BTC. So this is the wallet address. So if you copy this wallet address, okay, just like I have selected it, if I copy it now and send to anybody, anybody that send me Bitcoin will enter my Binance wallet. Now, if you go to withdrawal, it's the same thing, okay? If you go to withdrawal, here you select coin you want to withdraw, all right? Let's say I want to withdraw this USDT, this little USDT I have here. Now, you see recipient's USDT address. This is where you paste the wallet address you want to receive this USDT in. Then you see transfer network, like I explained in Bitcoin. You want to, they are withdrawing this USDT to a Binance wallet, a Binance enabled wallet. In Trust Wallet, you can withdraw USDT under Binance in Trust Wallet. Okay. The same, this is these two, just Binance. Then Ethereum, this is for if you are withdrawing this USDT to Ethereum wallet address, you select this network. If you are withdrawing to Omni, Omni is Bitcoin protocol. Okay, this is USDT. If you are withdrawing this USDT to a Bitcoin blockchain enabled wallet, then you select Omni. Tron, you already know Tron, which is TRC20. If you are withdrawing this to a Tron wallet address, then you select this network. Okay, then let me explain. Most of the times we get confused about this stuff. Now, USDT is one. Okay, USDT is one, just one. Okay, it's always equal to $1. But this whole network you see is because USDT is created in many blockchains. Okay, so the people dealing in Ethereum that want to pay somebody in Ethereum, they cannot use USDT under Tron to pay. They need to receive that USDT in Ethereum blockchain. It's still the same value. Okay, it doesn't reduce. It's simply just, it's just that they are, okay. Okay, look at it this way. USDT is one, okay, but they have different versions. Yes, USDT have different versions, okay. We have the ones running, we have USDT running on Ethereum, we have USDT running on Tron, we have USDT running on only Bitcoin, we have USDT running on Binance Smart Chain, but they are all one. The difference there is those who want to carry a transaction in Binance blockchain need to receive USDT using Binance protocol. Okay, those who are carrying a transaction in Ethereum blockchain need to use USDT in Ethereum blockchain. Now, you can accept the good part of Binance is if somebody is sending USDT, okay, maybe from Ethereum, and you want to withdraw it, you want the USDT in Tron, simply give that person your Binance wallet, okay? When that person sends that USDT here, you simply withdraw it now using Tron wallet address, and it will become USDT under Tron. So that is how good Binance is. Then Trust Wallet can accept any of this coin, any of this blockchain, because Trust Wallet is a cross-chain wallet, okay? So that is how to deposit and withdraw. Then this is fiat. In fiat, we don't have fiat. Fiat is your Naira, dollar, and all that. Nigeria has blocked all these things. They are no longer working. Okay? They are no longer working. This transaction I did here was when they were working before central bank released their news, okay? Then when you come here, you see orders. This is orders you have carried out, different order histories you have carried out in Binance. Then this is, if you click on this, this is just your dashboard to edit your information or to verify your Binance account, all right? Then this is notification, download if you want to download Binance app, either your mobile, your iOS, or your Android device. Then you can change your language here, and you can change the currency Binance is showing you each of these coins. So me, I leave it in USD, but if you want to change it to Naira, you can change it here. Just click commit. Okay, you select the currency you want and change it, and everything in Binance will start showing in that currency. So that is basically the overview and deposit and withdrawal of cryptocurrency exchange, if is equivalent to any other exchange. All right, then markets, coin market capitalization. All right, we'll go to coin market capitalization. Just a brief stop, I'll show you now. This is really taking longer than I expected. All right, so coin market cap, the website is coinmarketcap.com. Now, this is an aggregate website. Okay, this is the shows every cryptocurrency that is existing in the world. Okay, apart from ones that has not been registered here. All right, but this website shows every cryptocurrency that is existing in the world. Okay, is equivalent to Binance market section. Okay, top here, it shows you the total number of cryptocurrency that is in the world, which is 8,758 cryptocurrencies as of today, as of this moment, doing this webinar with you. Okay, then market, we have 35,665 cryptocurrency market in the world. Okay, then market capitalization. This is the total amount of money that has been traded into crypto industry from day one to date, which is $1.6 trillion. Okay, you can see this is a $1 trillion industry. Then 24 hours volume. This is the total amount that has been traded into cryptocurrency for the last 24 hours. Dominance. This is Bitcoin dominance. Okay, Bitcoin is having 60.1 dominance. This dominance simply means that Bitcoin is the most traded and most accepted cryptocurrency in the world, and its dominance is 60.1. Just imagine, of all these 8,758 cryptocurrency in the world, Bitcoin is having the total of 60.1 dominance. That is very, very high. Okay, so that makes it the giant and the king of cryptocurrencies. So then this website is where you can easily come and search for your coins, any coin you want to get more information on. Okay, here you see the names of the cryptocurrencies. Automatically, CoinMarketCap gives you first top 100 coins. Okay, the first one you can see here is Bitcoin. We have Ethereum, we have Binance Coin, we have Canoe, we have Tether, which is USDT, we have Polkadot, we have XRP. They are numerous. Just take your time later on. Then here, this is the current price of each of these coins. You can see these are the prices. 24 hours high. This is 24 hours in gain or in loss. The 24 hour percentage in gain or in loss. So Bitcoin has added 6.26% for the last 24 hours. Okay, 7 days. This is the total percentage in gain or in loss that Bitcoin has made, or any of this one has made for the last 24 hours. Market cap. This is the total amount of money that has been traded into Bitcoin since Bitcoin started existing. Okay, that is how much. One trillion plus. Okay, $1 trillion plus has been invested into Bitcoin since now. This is 24 hours volume. Okay, this is the total amount of money that has been traded into Bitcoin for the last 24 hours. Circulating supply. This is the total amount of Bitcoin that is circulation. Like all the ones you are receiving in your wallet, people are selling, is just all of them is 18.6 million Bitcoin plus. Okay, so you can click and click on each of these coins and find more information. So that is your coin market cap. All right, so let's go back to other things we have so that we can end. Now, understanding Satoshi value. please, if you are sleeping, wake up. Wake up. This is very, very important. Very, very important. If you don't know this, you will find it difficult. So pay close attention. Satoshi is the smallest part of Bitcoin, just like cent is to dollar, kobo to naira, pence to pounds. Okay, Satoshi is the smallest part of Bitcoin, just like we have naira and we have kobo. All right, so Satoshi is the smallest part of Bitcoin. So when they ask what is the smallest part of Bitcoin, you say Satoshi. Okay, Satoshi is taken from the name of the founder of Bitcoin, which is Satoshi Nakamoto. Okay, that is the organization. We don't know if he's a single person, we don't know if he's a group of persons. They are known as Satoshi Nakamoto. Okay, so they name the smallest part of Bitcoin after that people, after the person that invented Bitcoin, which is Satoshi. Okay, Satoshi value is the measurement of Bitcoin. So Satoshi value, which means Satoshi value is measurement of Bitcoin, just like Kobo value is measurement of Naira. Okay, 50 Kobo is half of 1 Naira. Okay, which means Kobo is the measurement of Naira. Bitcoin is measured in an 8-place decimal number. It simply means that after the first zero, after 0 points, you get solid 8 zeros. Okay, you get solid 8 zeros. All right. So Bitcoin is an 8-place decimal number. Bear it in mind. Then we are going into the calculation fully now. This is one Bitcoin. Let's take that one Bitcoin today. Forget whatever the price is, just focus on this lesson. One Bitcoin, let's take that one Bitcoin is $10,000. Okay. So it means that 0.00001 is equal to one Satoshi. In abbreviation of Satoshi is SAT. So if I ever tell you SAT, one SAT, 100 SAT, know that I'm talking about Satoshi. So it means that if one Bitcoin is $10,000 as of the time of this lesson, it means that 0.00001 is one Satoshi. Okay? It equally means that 0.1 is $1,000, which means 0.1 Bitcoin is what? $1,000. In other words, 0.1 is $1,000, which is 10% of the total amount of Bitcoin. All right? So 0.01 is $100. Okay? If we remember, we are taking the calculation assuming that Bitcoin is $10,000. Then 0.001 is $10. We have $1. We have 1 cent. We have 0.0 cents, and so on and so forth. Like you can see it here. Okay? Each one below is 10% of the one above. Okay, so 0.01 is 10% of 0.1, all right? So pay close attention, please. Take notes. Altcoins are valued against Bitcoin, all right? Altcoins are valued against Bitcoin. Sorry about that. Altcoins are valued against Bitcoin. Satoshi is fraction of a Bitcoin. Altcoins are measured in Satoshi. Please, this simply means that every cryptocurrency, remember I told you that altcoins are cryptocurrencies that are not Bitcoin. Okay, so every cryptocurrency in the market is valued against Bitcoin. Like you can use their value is always calculated using Bitcoin. Okay, it means that you can buy and sell each of these coins or measure the value using Bitcoin. Okay? And that part of Bitcoin you are using is the smallest part of Bitcoin, which is Satoshi. Okay? That is why number three says all coins are measured in Satoshi. And Satoshi is a fraction of a Bitcoin. Okay? Very, very important. Now, going further with this calculation, when you see 0.00001, it simply means one sat, which is one Satoshi. Okay, 0.00010 means 10 Satoshi. So if I ever tell you buy SOSO coin at 10 Satoshi, you understand that I'm talking of just 0.0010 Bitcoin. Okay, then 0.00100 is 100 Satoshi, we have 1,000 Satoshi, we have 10,000 Satoshi, we have 100,000 Satoshi, we have 1,000,000 Satoshi, and we have 10,000,000 Satoshi. Okay? So 10,000,000 Satoshi is 0.1. In other words, there is 100,000,000 Satoshi in one Bitcoin. Okay? Why 10,000,000 of it is 10% of the whole Bitcoin? Then you can always check and calculate your Satoshi value using bitcoinsatoshi.com. Okay? Using bitcoinsatoshi.com, I can quickly show you the website before we dive into question and answers. Sorry about this. Now, this is the website. You can come here and get Satoshi value. You can see the important Satoshi calculation here for you. Now, it's very, very vital you know Satoshi value. Very, very important. Very, very important. Like, if we go back to CoinMarketCap, I want to show you something. If you go back to CoinMarketCap, okay, CoinMarketCap has actually changed a lot. Now let's go to Binance, okay? If you go to Binance, go to that trade section. Let's use that classic, okay? We'll talk more on trade section in Binance in our tomorrow lesson. Hold on a bit, my network is a bit slow. So let me show you how important Satoshi value is so that you wouldn't play with it. Right, I'm going to select a different coin now. Okay. I just selected RV. Now you can see that the price of RV, look here closely, the price of RV is 7,899 Satoshi, which is $429.5. That is the value of the Satoshi you see here. So most of the times, you don't even, you looking at understanding the Satoshi value will help you a lot when you are buying and selling, and it will help you stop trying to always know, oh, what is this for? What is, why am I seeing this 000? Understand that this is the Satoshi value of this coin, okay? Then under it, because Binance is very good and they make everything simple, under it, they stated the value of this Satoshi above for you under it, okay? So that is how important Satoshi value is, all right? So that comes to the end of my lesson today, and we'll be taking questions, maybe like 5 questions, so that we can all go and rest for tonight and you comprehend on what you learned. So if you have a question, raise up your hand. I think that's raised up hand. Your name is Christo. Mr. Christo, good evening, sir. May you ask your question, sir? Unmute yourself and talk.
All right, sir. Good evening, Mr. Don. I must say that I'm very, very happy.
Please introduce
Hello?
Yourself
to us. Okay. All right. My name is Christo Chibweze. I'm a member of Time Hall. So I got the information about this lecture. So I decided to join and learn more about crypto.
Okay. So what's your question?
I want to thank you for the time you made out to lecture us about this very topic. But the question I have, I can say that we captured this, but at the same time, I get lost at some point. So I want to know if you have any kind of platform like YouTube or
that you can
rehearse. what you want to talk us
to. So I'll upload it on YouTube. Can you hear me, sir? Hello?
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 Yeah, I can hear you. I said I will upload it on YouTube.
Okay, on YouTube.
Yes, I will upload it on YouTube and I'll drop the link in the group.
Okay, all right. That would be great.
All right, that would be great.
You're welcome, sir. Okay, we have. I don't even know your name. The name is so, so hard to pronounce. I don't know, but the name is A-V-W-E-R-O something. If you know you are the one, please talk to us, unmute yourself, introduce yourself to the house, and ask your question.
Yeah, everybody. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, my name is Okay. Yeah, first of all, I want to thank you very much for this, for your training. We really appreciate it a lot. I have some few questions and also an observation.
Okay.
Let me start with the observation. I think the training you did today was cumbersome for we who are starting to learn this thing. Yeah, I think it's too much.
Yeah.
I would suggest if we take it bit by bit so that we're able to get it properly, because a lot of things have been said today, so I think it's too much for us to grasp for just a training. That is the observation.
Okay.
Then for my question. When you are logging into your Binance account, I noticed that you just type in your verification code. And each time I want to log into my Binance account, they always request that they are going to send me a verification code. Each time I log into the Binance account, they always request that they send me a verification code, either through my email address or through my registered mobile number. But your home, I noticed that it's like you just know your verification code and you just type it into it. So I don't know, is there any way that the previous one that they sent to me, can I still be using it? Or each time I log in, I must type in my verification code? That is one of my questions. Then two. When you are talking about the coin capitalization market, I don't think you got that one from the Binance account wallet. I think it's from the web. So I would love that if you can give us the website for the coin capitalization market, and also for that Satoshi. Then my last question is, can I transfer my Bitcoin or coins for it to be safe? Because in your training, you said Binance wallet is not that secure, but Trust wallet is secure. Is it possible to transfer my coins to my Trust wallet? Thank you very much.
Your observation, what I've loaded into your brain is too much. Okay, I understand that. Why this lesson is so lengthy like this is because it's so much. It will take almost a week. Okay, So I'm trying to, because of your schedules, depends, we all have different work and others that we do. Like the first person said, I will release the link to this video. Okay, you can watch it on your own spare time. Anytime you're tired, you pause it and you go on till you fully comprehend what we've done today. Okay, then in frequent lessons, I will try to maybe minimize the content so that it will just be easy for you to understand. Then, talking about the code, what I used, I didn't use text message or email message. Okay, I used Google Authenticator. Okay, Google Authenticator works like your normal hard token that bank gives you. If you have ever collected hard token from bank, that device they give you that shows you a code that when you want to transfer 1 million and above, you need to provide the code from that device. Now, Google Authenticator is just an app you install on your phone. Okay, it's an additional security in Binance. All right, so let me quickly show you that. Sorry, everyone, it will be so quick. And I know we are tired. I need to log out so that I can log in. Okay. Now, if you see here, look closely, you see it's written here, Google verification code, okay? So I simply just opened my app, the Google Authenticator app I have in my phone, and type in the code here, all right? Then you can see I can equally switch to phone verification. If I click on switch to phone verification, you can see the one you're talking about. I can request a code from Binance now on my mobile number to log into Binance. This is an additional security that I set on Binance. If you go to your Binance account, go to that your profile, you will see where you can set. You can see where you can set about where you can set your Google Authenticator. They are going to give you a special code which you will insert in Google Authenticator Authenticator app. Now that app will constantly be generating codes for you anytime you want to log in. And it's more secure than your mobile number, because if someone is in position of your mobile number, a person can log into this account. But if you're in position of my mobile number and I don't have this Google Authenticator in my phone, you are wasting your time. So it's an additional security. The both are two different stages of verification. Okay, the phone you are using is normal basic verification. Okay, yeah, it's very high, but the authenticator is more solid than this phone verification. So you can simply set it on your Binance account. Okay, then you asked if you can send your coins to Trust Wallet. Yes, you can send your coins to Trust Wallet, but if you are a trader, okay, if you're a trader, you buy and sell often, you leave your coins on Binance. But what I'm saying is, for long term, a coin you are keeping for like 6 months, 7 months, please don't leave it on Binance. A lot could happen within that period of time, all right? But because you're a trader, you're always in the market, you can easily take off some of your coin even before before 1 month. So don't get confused about that, okay? But if you are kind of that security-minded person, you can just want to transfer everything out, but it's going to be a kind of stress and costing you more transaction withdrawal fees, okay? Anytime you are transferring them out. So I will advise that if you are a trader and trade often, leave your coin on Binance. But know that the coin you are leaving on Binance is coin you are trading. This is in form of you having a shop. In your shop, you sell, okay, you have a provision stock. Then you still have a warehouse where you pack a lot of things that you've not taken to the shop yet. Okay, so if somebody bungle your shop, The person just stole things that were in the shop, but not the warehouse is still filled. So that is how it is. So the warehouse you are talking about now is like Trust Wallet, and the shop is what? Your Binance Wallet. I hope you understand what I explained, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. If you missed note five, please ask your question so that we can end on.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. Hello. Good evening, everyone. My name is Robinson Ije.
First of all,
thank you very much. First of all, I want to commend you for this webinar that you've organized for us today. Me, especially as a beginner, I'll say at least I'm 40% up in base of the knowledge you've given to us today. Even if, like the other man said, there's too much information for we beginners. I don't have any idea about it. Also, I must still say thank you because this abolition, you are really done indeed. The way you broke it down from the content, crypto assets qualification, wallet, exchange, common market capitalization, it means you know what you are doing. Now you say you have been in this since 2015. Well done, boss. Thank you very much. Well, then my question is, if a crypto asset occurrence is just for deposit and withdrawal, how do one now make money from crypto? Then, what is really the best wallet to use if you want to secure our currency or our coins? Then, lastly, this crypto, how do we make money from it? Is it just by deposit and withdrawing? I don't really know which one, because me, I really want to make money and not just buy Bitcoin, then sell Bitcoin. I believe that there's no much, you can't really do much on that. Then lastly, please, I want to plead with you. This Binance you taught us today is like a course on its own. If maybe by his grace, you can create that time and just educate us on that Binance platform. So that some of us, me, I'm not in Binance. From what you have taught, download that Binance.
I'm familiarized
with that platform. So I'll be needing your knowledge too on that aspect. That's why I'm pleading that you create that a time to just educate us on that Binance. That is all. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Okay. You asked for the best wallet to use. Like I said, you can use blockchain wallet and you can use Trust Wallet. Personally, I'll tell you what I do, okay? Because anything I'm telling you is what I do. So that if you call me tomorrow, I'll tell you, yes, this is what I do. Now, I use Trust Wallet often, okay? The reason is because Trust Wallet gives me that ability to receive any coin I want to receive, okay? Because it's a cross-chain wallet. Like, in Trust Wallet, you can switch Trust Wallet into blockchain. Okay, so that is why I use Trust Wallet often, and I make sure that my private key and my mnemonic phrase is highly hidden. Okay, I don't share with friends, I don't share with family members. It's my own personal property because that is fully access to my coins. Then you ask how you can make money from crypto. Okay, you can make money from crypto two ways. Okay, forget what we do with MMM and FOSTA. These things are just only. Now, for you to make money from crypto, you create cryptocurrency or you invest in cryptocurrency. Now, let me give you an example. Do you know that if you are buying $10 of Bitcoin every month, that from 2020, at the end of 2020, Bitcoin was around $12,000 or even $10,000. Now Bitcoin is around $54,000. Please, do you know that 10,000 naira Bitcoin you have been buying every month from 1st January 2020 now will buy you a very classic vehicle, like small saloon car? Do you know that the money you get from that 10,000 naira that you are taking out from your salary every month and you are putting it into Bitcoin as an investment has been able to turn to something else. That is a means to make money from cryptocurrency. Okay. The second means to make money from cryptocurrency is to buy potential coin when they are down, and when they increase, they can give you 100%, 30%, 20%, and you make your money. So that is how you make your money from cryptocurrency. Okay. If you master them properly, you can spot potential coins. Okay, but we'll talk more on that in our next lesson. Okay, so that is how you make your money from cryptocurrencies. I hope your question is answered, sir.
Yes, it's answered.
Hello, sir.
Yes. Yeah, I can hear you. I say yes. Right, yes.
All right, thank you. I really appreciate the time. I'm so sorry to keep you this time of the day. Okay, I promise to be a bit quicker and easier. Just that I wanted to be more explanatory today. Okay. See you all tomorrow. Have a wonderful night. Keep the spirit high. Don't feel bored. Don't feel it's too lengthy. You cannot learn it. There is nothing you cannot learn. You cannot learn something when you tell yourself, I cannot learn. Okay, your brain will stop working. But tell yourself you want to learn and you want to, you know, discover more of this. I want you to know that what you started today could be a life-changing opportunity for you. Only if you can see it and believe in it. But you will see it by the time I meet you tomorrow. Okay. So good night, everyone. Have a wonderful day, a wonderful night, I need to say. Bye.